For torque to exist in a system with multiple masses, we require non-rigid objects. In this video, we will model non-rigid objects as a collection of spheres connected to each other by invisible springs. Each sphere is connected by invisible springs to all of its immediate neighbors in the vertical, horizontal, and diagonal directions. In reality, all objects are non-rigid, since the speed of sound through a perfectly rigid object would be infinite, thereby violating Einstein's theory of relativity. A perfectly rigid object would also violate classical Newtonian physics, because torque would not work properly for a perfectly rigid object. Before moving on to torque, let's watch how our model behaves in various scenarios. In order to illustrate the concepts, we'll exaggerate the effects of non-rigidity by using a model with weak spring constants. Though these concepts work for even a slightly non-rigid object, where the deformations are too small to be noticed. Suppose we have zero gravity present. Suppose we have a fixed axis of rotation. Let's apply two forces of equal magnitude on the object that try to rotate the object in opposite directions around the axis. As the torque equation predicts, the force further away from the axis of rotation wins out. However, the torque equation is not actually programmed into our physics simulation. Instead, the movements of the spheres are calculated exclusively using Newton's three laws of linear motion. The forces that two neighboring spheres exert on each other always lie along the line joining the two spheres. This is the strong version of Newton's third law of motion. The weak version of Newton's third law of motion just states that the forces two masses exert on each other must be equal and opposite. The strong version of Newton's third law of motion states that in addition to being equal and opposite, the two forces must also lie along the line joining the two masses. This additional constraint is required for the conservation of angular momentum. It is also required to obtain the correct torque equation for a system containing multiple masses. If we were to assume that the object in our example is perfectly rigid, we would incorrectly conclude that the internal forces inside the object do not obey the strong version of Newton's third law, thereby forming pairs of forces that cause the object to generate self-torque. But if each pair of spheres in our model can only generate a force along the line connecting the two spheres, how is it possible that the external downward force on the right part of the object is causing an upward force on the left part of the object? After all, the external downward force on the right part of the object does not lie along the same line as the upward force on the left part of the object. In order to understand this, let us apply stronger forces, thereby making the non-rigid behavior of the object more obvious. Here, we can see that the object deforms, and as the invisible springs internal to the object try to straighten the object out, they cause the left part of the object to move upward. This deformation is required for the torque equation to work properly. In most cases, the deformation is so small that we don't notice it. Nevertheless, this deformation is always present because there is no such thing as a perfectly rigid object. Special thanks to all the people supporting us on Patreon. Your support is very much appreciated. Torque is explained in the video, Torque, Levers, and the Universal Law of Rotation.